All right, he's the owner of New York's Le Bernardin. And he's here to share some delicious recipes from his new book, Vegetable Simple. Please welcome back to the show my French cousin, Chef Eric Repair.
Hello, cousin.
Hello, cousin. Very good to see you.
It's great to see you, too.
It smells so good in here. Why do vegetables smell so good when prepared by French people?
Because, well, we have Herbe de Provence. So that smells pretty good.
It really does.
Yeah, right? Mm. I love it.
Me too.
And we are going to make some tomatoes with Herbe de Provence. And we are going to make
heaven.
A mushroom with a beurre d'escargot.
Amazing.
Snail butter?
Yes, snail butter. Yes, our favorite. Look at Ryan. I mean, don't be distracted by the man jumping in the corner.
I'm right now in Aix-en-Provence picturing the gardens.
Okay, take us through. How do we start?
So we are going to put some olive oil in a pan to begin with. Mm-hmm. Like that. And we are generous, always.
Always generous.
We make the pan pretty hot.
Okay.
And then we are splitting the tomatoes in half. Like this, so that's pretty simple, of course.
Oh.
And that's the name
of the book. Okay, that's the wrong way.
Simple.
I'm going to do it this way.
So we have salt on top of it.
Yes.
Like this, a lot of salt because
now, is this the wrong kind of salt? Wouldn't you prefer like a coarser salt?
I like, this one is the one I don't understand, but it's okay.
Oh, and we're putting pepper on it as well?
Yes, we're putting pepper.
Okay.
I find a way.
This way? No. Twist. Well, Eric doesn't understand it either, Gelman, so. The chef doesn't understand your peppermint.
You can stop, it's okay.
Okay, sorry. Sorry, I get enraged, so.
Now we're going to put a lot of Herbe de Provence.
Thank you.
On each of them, like that.
Just like this.
So, but a lot of it.
I wish that everyone could smell the television.
Right, it's nice.
Now. Oh, my
gosh. And then we flatten well. Mm-hmm. With our hand, and they're fully covered. We're going to make a nice crust with it. And we go, I think you're good. Then we go face down
face
in
down.
A pan, and all those pans are really hot. I love it.
Mm.
And you see, it's going to create such a nice. We're going to create such a nice crust, and the tomatoes are going to be very soft, almost like a jam, right?
Mm, yes, yes.
And that's going to be very nice.
While
the tomatoes are cooking, we have plenty of time.
Okay.
So what we are going to do, we are going to stuff some crimini mushroom.
Yes.
With the beurre d'escargot.
Perfect.
So the beurre d'escargot, I have some butter here. We have actually a big bowl.
Okay.
You have it too, I think.
Have it here, yeah.
And we're going to put it here. So the butter is soft.
Yes.
You see, like, it has to be soft because we are going to mix in it. Some garlic.
Okay, garlic.
Like this. And we are going to add some chopped parsley.
Mm.
All of it. A bit of salt again, and the black pepper that you master so well. And then we mix it really, really, really well like that. You see?
Yes.
And during that time, our tomatoes are cooking, of course.
Mm-hmm. And how long do they usually cook for? It depends
the tomatoes?
On...
tomatoes?
Yeah.
Well, we have to look at... we have a spatula here, look.
Just a
sometimes
little...
Sometimes you lift it a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Just
you
a
look
peek.
To make sure that they don't burn. They don't, which is it's really good. Because the moisture prevents the herbs from
yes.
burning. Then we take the mushroom and with the back of the spoon, I'm going to remove the stem.
Okay.
So we go like this. You see, like that, and we remove it.
Oh, look at that.
And the reason why we do that is because we have a bigger hole to
yes.
stuff with the butter.
Mm-hmm.
So we do that. I have another one. So we do the same.
With mushrooms, refresh my memory, we don't wash them, right? We brush them?
No, those ones do not need to be washed because they are pretty clean when you buy them at the supermarket or any market, the crimini mushroom. So the butter that we just made, actually, we're going to use it, and we're going to put it on top of it like this.
Oh, my goodness.
You see, like, covered nicely?
Are you listening to Ryan moaning? Moaning.
I hear it. Yeah, this is a good sign. I mean, they're not even cooked.
It doesn't matter. He'll eat them raw.
And so I'm putting them like this. And they go in this plate.
Just
right
like that.
Here. We're going to cover it with a bit of breadcrumb.
Okay.
So we have some toasted breadcrumb right here.
Do you make the breadcrumbs yourself?
I buy it.
You buy it. Okay, good. That makes me feel better.
If you really want to.
Yeah.
And they're going to go in oven.
Okay.
At 425 for about 10 minutes.
Okay.
Until they become very, like, crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
And while they are in oven, so I'm putting them in oven right here.
Okay.
While they go in oven, I'm going to flip the tomatoes.
Okay.
And you see, look at that crust.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's where all the flavor is.
I mean, look at me multitasking, Gelman. I just flicked my crust right off.
Look at, I mean, that crust is really nice. You have the same one, actually.
Yes, but your crust looks... Oh, okay.
More crusty?
Yeah, it's okay. No, yeah, yours is okay.
So then, thank you. Then the mushrooms, when they're ready, they grit as a canapé.
They really are.
Or as a side dish with, like, white meat or something like that. Yeah, we can have one, of course.
Cheers. Salute. To you. When we return, Ryan is going to join Chef Eric Repair in the kitchen, and he's going to consume all of this.
Amazing, amazing. Bienvenue avec mon ami, Chef Eric Repair.
I don't know. That's right. C'est français, oui.
Oui, no. Listen.
Well,
I'm breaking my window
and
fasting for Chef Eric Repair. It's happening. Yeah. Now, you've spent your entire life, seemingly, being drawn to fish. And here we are with vegetables in the new book, right? Beautiful, beautiful book, by the way.
Thank you very much.
And it's plant-based, and now we're going to do broccolini.
Yes.
Okay, let's start.
That's what we are going to do.
I'm going to have my first course while I make a second course.
By the way, may I just add, it really is simple. The vegetables and the way you bring out the flavors, anybody can do it. Even I can do it, Ryan.
You're
eating what I just cooked.
And it's brilliant.
Yeah, and vegetables have a lot of flavor, and it's... You don't need to complicate recipes when you cook vegetables. You need to have very fresh ingredients
and keep
that are in season.
Mm-hmm.
And you follow your instinct when you go shopping and so on. If the lettuce is wilted, you don't buy it.
Right. Okay.
And then it's pretty simple. You use simple techniques.
Okay, let's do broccolini.
So, broccolini. So we're going to put some olive oil.
Very generously.
Very generously, always.
Okay.
And the broccolinis.
Broccolini.
So it's basically like a kind of a cousin of the broccoli.
Sure, it's the ripa of the ripa.
Too much. So like that.
Okay.
Yeah. And a bit of salt.
Okay.
Wow. Yes. You like olive oil, like me.
Oh, I love olive oil.
And we can even put some of the red flag hot peppers.
Okay.
Because they're gonna release their oil while they're cooking, right?
Okay.
And do you know how to use a knife well?
No.
Okay. So I'm going to show you how to slice the garlic very thinly.
Okay.
So the garlic, first of all, we're going to split it in half, the clove, like that, so it doesn't slide on the cutting board.
Okay.
And then look well the movement. The knife
does
like
that.
From
it's going
to
rock.
Here.
It's going to rock.
And then your finger is going to guide the blade. Whoa. Here.
I watch you.
Yeah, like this. So the blade stays... against the finger, so you cannot slide.
I see.
And you go very thin, very, very, very thin. Like, yes.
Okay.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Then we do the other half, because we need it for the recipe. Yes,
right, okay,
like that,
good.
You don't cut yourself, you don't hurt yourself.
Okay.
And we are going to add the garlic in it.
Okay.
So it's very simple. This one is ultra simple.
I like lots of garlic.
Ultra fast.
Has anybody ever lost a finger in the kitchen?
Sometimes it happens, yes.
But if you find it, you get a free meal. All right.
No, I have been lucky. I have never seen someone losing his finger.
I love his candor. All right, so we're cooking.
So we are cooking them like that. And you can see the garlic is becoming softer.
Yeah.
They change color.
The aroma is amazing.
Can smell, right?
Yeah.
Even the pepper smells.
Yep. I smell it.
And after 5 minutes, they're going to be tender.
Okay.
So we have... Exactly.
We have them right here.
We have them right here.
Ooh.
And they are tender. The garlic is crunchy, which I love. And you have the spiciness.
It is so healthy, so simple. Mm-hmm. We just did it. Listen, you are...
Thank you.
You're a genius. Le Bernardin is open. It's pumping. Get there if you're in New York City. Pick up a copy of Eric's new book, Vegetables Simple, where books are sold. And go to kellyandryan.com for all the recipes and more.
Like
kellyandryan.com. We come back with a good news story of the day. Au revoir.
Thank you.